Hello friends, welcome to my video. In this video I will design a simple counter in app designer, and I will also show the use of various widgets in app designer and doing some cool stuff in app designer in this video. For the counter, for the counting, I will try to use a MATLAB functions rather than using functions within the MATLAB within the app designer class. So I will try to access the MATLAB functions which are outside of app designer and use the global variable concepts. And also I will later show you how you can do it using Simulink model as well. How you can take the input for the counters from Simulink model. So let's start. So let's first create our app designer. I'll create a very simple one. So here it comes. So once it comes, you can just okay, so for app designer, what we will need is probably counter. So it shows what is my current number. So everything will be, I think, just read only text, because we don't need to write anything or edit anything. The user don't have to edit anything on this layout. So I'll just put a label here. One more label probably on the top to explain what it is all about. So this is like total count. Total count, yes. I'll make it probably a little bigger. Size I'll increase to probably 16. Yes. For label, I'll probably give an initial value of 0. This will show me my what is my current count. I'll make this also probably 20. Yes. And also probably I will show you some kind of like a status, what is currently happening. So this can be either increase or decrease, but initially, so I'll make it probably a little bigger. Yes. And size should be probably 20 or probably more than that, 24. And yes, but initially I'll keep it blank, because I will do it programmatically in my program. Yeah, so this goes blank. So once it goes blank, you won't be able to see if there's any label box here. So we will have to use our right hand side to do what we want. And also let's keep a button using which we can start. You can use other mechanism also to start the counting, but button is something very explicitly I can control myself. So start. Yeah. So this was my simple layout. Let me save this. So I will give the name counter app designer. So once we have this, so let's start with the callback. So we'll put the callback of this start function. In fact, that's the only place where you can put the callbacks, because others are just labels, so they won't have the callbacks if you are able to observe here. So we can just have a callback in the start button, and we just create a callback here, and over here it comes. So now in this callback, what are the things which we can do is, so let's first make it simple, and let's first try to increment or decrement our value over here. So for that, what are the things which we'll need is, first we will have something like, probably we can put a switch case condition. So switch case, and let's take a random integer of maximum of 2. So this rand, sorry, spelling mistake, rand i of 2 will return me either value 1 or 2. So case when it returns 1, that time what it should do is, probably it should, let's assume for 1 it will increase. So let me increase, and so the value of this label, so this is nothing but app.label. When you select it over here in the app layout, this particular component gets highlighted in the component browser. So we have to increase the value of this by 1. So what we can do is, we can increase the value, or probably what we can do is, we can have an initial counter value over here, and then we can have this. So counter, let's assign it to 0. Yes, or rather let's do it this way, that let's make this as a global variable. So we have to just use global keyword for that, global counter. And once you have made global variable, then we have to use this if is empty, the same concept what we use for this persistent variable also, that if this object is empty, then we should do this, then we should assign it a value of 0. So this is like initialization, and then we do end. So what we I'm doing over here is this will just initialize it 0 for the first time. For all the other times, it will take the value from the same position where this particular variable has been created. So yeah, since I'm using this global, so it will be shared across all the MATLAB functions. So probably for increase, what we can do now is we can write a separate function called increment. And I will write it later on. Probably let me see if they give some options to open increment. It will say, does not exist. Do you want to create it? Yes, let me create one. So it will just create quickly function increment. Okay. And over here, what I can do is again I can take the same variable as that counter what I defined earlier. Okay, so it doesn't come in the hint menu, that's fine, because I think it's still not initialized in the workspace or somewhere, so it's still not able to recognize it. And then I can do is counter equal to counter plus 7 and yes. And probably before I move back to my app designer code, I let me create one decrement function as well. So this is I'm creating separate MATLAB functions which is outside of my app designer, and I can call it from my app designer. And the memory how we are sharing is using this global concept. Yes. So this is for decrement, and I'm just doing it minus. So the rest of the things remain same. So if I go back to my app designer now, so this is for increment, and case 2 will be for my decrement. Yeah. And I'll do the other stuff as well. So but before that, let me verify if this is being identified or not. Yeah, this is being identified. When I right click and did go to, it goes to the correct function. So there is no shadow, nothing else. Just verify, this is a good practice in MATLAB or any other programming language. You should always verify the functions which is being called, either by debugging or by using these techniques. Okay, so over here, after you increment, what are the things which we have to set is, we have to set this value of the counter to this correct label. So this app label, and app label is in text form. So we have to set it in the text format. So we'll do this app dot label, no, label dot text. We have to do text as well. Text equal to, and this is in the numerical format. This is integer, so we may have to change it from num to string, and then we have to use this counter. Yes, and once we have done this, what are the other things which we have to set is, probably we'll set the label 2, which is not visible, which we left it blank initially. We will set some kind of string to it. So app dot label underscore 2 text equal to, say for example, increased. Yes. And let's also toggle the color. That was a request by one of my audience, that if I can have a toggling color also in my app designer. So let's see if we can give a color to this or not. So for that, the steps are very simple. One way is you can just select this, and then down here you can select the color over here, font color. Otherwise we'll do it programmatically. But before we do it programmatically, I would like to show you something over here. That the font color concept which MATLAB follows is RGB. First is R, second is G, and third is B. I mean red, green and blue, which are the primary colors in the color formats. So probably for when it's increasing, will show it green. So when we do green, if you see R remains 0, green becomes 1 and blue remains 0. Okay, so we'll use the same thing programmatically over here. So we will do app.label2. This is font color, so we'll use font color, this second option, equal to, and then we will give this in this brackets. The first is 0, which is R, green is 1, and then blue is 0. So this is the font color. So apart from this, I think we have set this label, the increment in the counter, and this. I think it should work fine. Now let's go to the case 2 and do the same thing in case 2 as well. So, or probably we can just copy paste, because most of the lines of the code will remain same apart from minor modification. So once we have this case 2, we can have a instead of increase, the text will change to decrease, and probably I'll double the color to red, and this one, yes. Okay, so now let's run quickly and see if it works or not. See, it's happening, and since we have used this random number, randi over here, so you can't predict what will be the next case. Yeah, but it's going into minus. So say for example, if you want to restrict the value of this to only 0 or plus, let's do that as well. We can in this place, we can just put a condition check that if my counter value goes less than 0, then make it 0. So this way it will never go to negative. So say for example, if you are counting something, say for example your chickens or your eggs or your chocolates, then it will never go to negative. It will either be 0 or positive. So in those cases, this if condition could be helpful. So I'll just rerun this again, and if I do it, so see, if it's decreasing, it's not going to the minus. No, it's plus. So it will always be plus or 0. Yeah. Of course, you can have more switch case and more logics implemented here. Okay. So this was a nice example. So now let's do it a little different. Now, as I told in the initial part of this tutorial, that I will also show you how we can take the inputs from a Simulink model rather than doing this random number generation from here. Let's take it from Simulink model and try to connect it Simulink model output to this app designer over here. So for that, we'll go to our MATLAB and we'll just create a simple Simulink model quickly. Yes, blank template. And once we have this template, what are the things which we can do is we can have a random number generator, which is over here, random number. And meaning I'll just leave it like this. And so if you are aware, this random number will do nothing but it just generates a random number based on this mean value and variance. So if you are interested, let's just quickly put a scope and take that scope value over here and see what it happens. We are simulating just a random number, and in the scope you can see the output. So it just creates some kind of random number between minus 2 and plus 2. So what we can do is we can use a switch case over here that validates whether the value is above 0 or less than 0. So let's quickly put a switch, and in this switch what we can do is probably we can then disconnect. We don't need this to connect it there directly, and we need to connect it directly to over here. And once we have this, we connect this scope here, and now we need probably two constant blocks. One will return probably value of 1 is fine, and I'll need one more block with a value of 2, because if you remember in our code we are doing the comparison with 1 and 2. So 1 means increment and 2 means decrement. Yeah, so if I simulate this now, it should return me either 1 or 2, and this is random number, so you won't be able to know when is 1 and when is 2. So to get this output into my app designer, we can use something called 2 workspace or 2 file also, but I will use the 2 workspace block, and the variable name I can use is probably counter variable, and I will read this variable value over there in my counter, and then based on that, so this will be my condition that whether it has to be increased or decreased. So once I've done this, I'll just quickly save this. So I'll save this using method called, probably I'll name it counter condition. Yeah, so I just simulated once again, and it should be random number. This pattern should not be repeated, but I can see it's repeating, so I'm not sure, but this should be a random number from Simulink. Yes, so once we have done this, our Simulink modeling, we'll go back to our app designer. We can close this for the time being because we will change our algorithm a little bit, and over here what we can do is we can read the value of this variable counter from Simulink. So when you run it, it becomes like a variable in MATLAB workspace. So we need to read this value in our app designer code. So what we can do is, instead of this switch case, we can probably comment it out, and we need a new switch case. New switch, and over here we can read that value, whether that's 1 or 2. So that value is counter variable, counter variable dot data. You can verify that which particular, with this in a structure format, that's a structure, so you have to take the data out of it, and that data we have to use it over here in the switch case. And what we can do is, since this is almost a lot of data, around 1 times, so it will flicker a lot of times, so we can use probably a kind of for loop before this. That for I equal to 1, 2, again I can use this data, and and then of course everything will be done, and over here I can use this end. To again just quickly do the indentation, you can just select all the code and just right click and do the smart indentation, so it will take care of all the matching positions. Yeah, so over here once you have done it, probably since data is a series over here, so we have to select the right sequence, so we will give this array that index of the data which we want, and one by one it will do. To make it a little more like visible for your, this will also work fine, but it will do it very fast, so we can give a bit of pause to this, and we can see it how it actually happens one by one. So a pause of 1 second, so this complete set of data will complete in 1 second, because it will wait for 1 second after each execution. So let's run now and see what happens. So once I click a start, undefined variable or class counter variable, so okay, so when this variable is defined there, yeah, okay, so this is, yeah, although this variable exists, but this data is a structure, since for loop we can't take a structure, so actually what we have to do is we have to take the length of this particular structure, because we have to read this 101 times, so that will be written by a API called length in MATLAB. So I'll just use length, and now let me try out if it works. So I run this again, and now if I click this, undefined, but this, as far as I know, this does exist in the my MATLAB environment. And okay, so this does exist, but I think I'm getting it what is happening here. Since this is in the base workspace and we are trying to take it in the one of the functions in MATLAB, so it won't work. So now we have two options. Either we fetch the value from the base workspace using evalin command, or otherwise what we can do is we can simulate the model right from here. So we'll use a sim command for that, and then we'll give the model name. We'll use this syntax one to fourth one, and then we have to give this model name over here, which is our this one counter condition, and I just type it like this, and I think it should work this time. This time it should be. So this was a nice practice where we are debugging one by one. Yes, you can see. So of course it's only, okay, no, it's decreasing. I thought like whether my Simulink model is only giving the increasing value. So if you see, you have got 1 second time and it's increasing or decreasing, and it will go on till 100 seconds approximately, because the amount of data which is returned by Simulink is 100 times. Of course you can modify your Simulink model to give more or less data by playing with the total time and the timestamp in the Simulink model configuration parameters, but for the time being I'll just keep it simple. So if you see, our counter is working perfectly fine and it's increasing and decreasing, and based on that our color is changing of the text. In one of my audience also requested whether we can have it connected to Arduino board. I'm not sure, I will not cover that in this video, but I'll just quickly show. In the meantime, it's running in the background anyway. That what you can do is you can go to your MATLAB and then go to your add-ons, and then this get hardware support packages, you can click here and it should bring up one more window. So I think it's waiting for this to close, so probably I'll just close it. Yes, I think it was hanged because of that. So once you click that, you'll get this kind of page. So where you can see on the first menu will be first option, at least I get it, is support package for Arduino hardware. I have already installed it on my machine, so you can just click and follow the steps and you can install it, and then you can connect your Arduino board to your MATLAB environment, and then you can use respective scripts what you develop in your MATLAB environment to connect to these Arduino boards. Okay, so I hope it was useful for you, this video. For any questions, please do put in my comment section. If you like my video, please subscribe to my channel, and thank you for watching it. Bye.